going to walk you guys through the step on a cross-compiling applications from an x86 or 64-bit computer to an ARM processor. My target device will be a Beaglebone Black, which of course uses the ARM processor. So I will be using Eclipse, and we're going to need to install the SDT plugin for Eclipse. And then after that, we'll install the toolchain. Then you got to link Eclipse to the toolchain. And that's pretty much it. After that, you write your application, compile it, transfer it to your device, and run it. So I'm going to guide you through those three steps. Now, you would want to do this because compiling on the BeagleBone will be a really slow process. So let's say you want to compile a large library, like the point cloud library. You would want to compile it on your desktop computer, cross-compile it, and transfer the binary over to the target device. So I'm going to show you how to set up the environment to get that going. The first step would be to install Eclipse. Now, I'm doing this in Arch Linux. There's tons of guides for Ubuntu, but basically it doesn't matter what Linux you're running, the commands are the same. The commands are a little different for each distro, but the idea is the same. So let's install Eclipse. If you're on a Debian or Ubuntu machine, you would do sudo apt-get Eclipse and hit enter, but on Arch Linux it uses pacman, so you do sudo pacman s-s to install, and we'll do Eclipse, and we could install the Eclipse SDD plugin right from here. In Ubuntu you could do that. I'm not sure if you could do that or not, but I'll show you how to do it from inside Eclipse, how to install that CDT plugin. So we'll hit enter. I've already installed it, but I might as well just hit, it's pretty fast. So after this is done installing, I will open it and show you how to install the CDT plugin if you didn't install it through here. That's the plugin that's being installed right now. Now let's load Eclipse. Right now, Eclipse would be using your compiler GCC for your desktop machine. It's not set to ARM, the ARM processor. That's all we have to do is set it to the ARM toolchain. But first we want to compile C++ files, so we want to install the CDT plugin. Okay, so after you've opened Eclipse, in order to install the CDT plugin, you need to hit help, go to install new software, then paste this site in. I'll have this site in the description on the YouTube video. Or you could just type it from looking at the screen, it doesn't matter. So add that site. Then here you could install CDT. I would just install all of that. Then hit next, and install. But I already have it installed, so I don't need to do that. Now, we could close Eclipse for now, because we need to install the toolchain. Now we can move on to step two. The toolchain it's the same package pretty much for Ubuntu or for Arch. It's ARM Linux, GNUEAV, GCC, but Arch Linux has this handy cross-compiling script that you could install crosstool-ng, and it'll download the toolchain and install it for you. I have already done that on my computer. All you have to do is go to this site. I'll also paste this site in the YouTube link, and you could either install it using a pre-built toolchains, or you could do this. I chose to do this way, and it worked out easy. Just copy and paste these commands into your command line and follow the instructions, and when you're done you'll have an installed toolchain. Now if you don't want to go that route and you want to go the AUR route and install from there, you probably have this program, YAURT, yet another AUR package manager. would just search for the ARM Linux packages inside the AUR, and I would install this one. Or, I mean, I have a couple installed. These seem to work the best. Is just install this one right here. Or this one. Install, you're gonna want to install this one. So let's install that one. Well, I already have it installed. So after you install that, you'll just hit 23. It's gonna go through the install process. It'll ask you if you wanna hit cancel. After you've installed it, you could look at your binaries by typing ARM Linux and hit tab a few times. Then you'll see all the binaries you have installed. Now these are what you're gonna want to type into Eclipse. So we've already installed the toolchain, whether you did it using distcc and crosstool, which I recommend to go this route, just copy these commands, or you did it from the AUR. Either way, the binaries of the toolchain are installed on your system. So you're ready to link Eclipse. Now let's open up Eclipse again. And then we'll start a new project. We'll write a simple Hello World program. And then we'll compile it in. We'll compile it for the ARM architecture. It's not going to run on our computer, so that'll be good if it doesn't. Now let's start a new project in Eclipse. C++ project. Doesn't matter what you pick here, we're going to change it. We'll do a Hello World project. Let's give it a name. We'll do cross ARM test. Next. Finish. That's fine. That's totally cool. Now hit finish. So here we have a simple program if we want to build it right now. Hit Control V, that builds it. And then we'll run it. And hopefully, there it is, hello world. So this compiled for our desktop. Now this is not gonna run the ARM, so let's configure it to run the same application on the BeagleBone. To do that, you'll have to go to your project properties. So go to your Solution Explorer. Hit properties. Then go to C++ build, settings. These are the values you want to change. Right now they're set to your desktop, GCC, G++. You go here and depending on whichever package you installed, you'll kind of match it. So this is GCC. Now you'll want to install ARM GCC. So you copy this one, and you'll paste it here. Or you can type it. Now, in my case, I have them. Right here, I have the binaries installed in this folder. So, so here are the binaries that I want. to change these. So I want GCC. I'll highlight it. Copy. Paste it here. Then cross G++. Get the C++ binary. Copy it. Paste it here. Now this one, you'll notice it's a G++ again. So you can just paste the same one. And this one is AS. So find the AS. Copy that. Put it in here. Let's make sure that we got them all right. GCC, GCC, G++, C++, G++, the linker, right, and the assembler should be AS. Perfect, so now we hit OK. Now we go back to our project, and we'll build it. This time it's going to rebuild it using the ARM toolchain. Now that it has been built, let's try to run it. It's not going to work. Yeah, nothing should happen because it doesn't work. Alright, so now let's transfer our executable to the Beaglebone Black, and we'll run it on the Beaglebone Black through SSH. So the first thing we need to do is change the directory into wherever our Eclipse saved the binary of that file. So CD, I'm pretty sure it's a workspace. Saved it under debug. Send cross arm test over to the BeagleBone. We'll use a program called SCP, which sends the file over SSH. My BeagleBone is connected to a network. It's connected to the network through a different computer. So its IP address is .167. It's usually .7.2. Wait, that is the BeagleBone. Then you do :/. I'm going to put it in home, just because I know that's a directory. I don't want to mess this up. So I'm going to transfer. I'm going to transfer this program over. Don't forget to type the actual file you want to transfer. Yes. Good. Now we're going to SSH into the BeagleBone. So SSH into your BeagleBone. Right now I'm inside the BeagleBone. And we're going to want to change the directory into the home directory. See, there is our executable. If everything went well, we should be able to run it. You need to make it an executable first. Now let's run it. And look, there we go. There's our program. It works on the BeagleBone. Now you can compile any application from your desktop computer to any ARM machine, like the BeagleBone in my case. Thanks for watching.